the time we actually start our class. So welcome everybody to our Zoom class. We're in my screen and porch area today, so we have a lovely, lovely view of the trees, kind of. It looks a little muted, but okay. So just before we get started, kind of giving Sandy a moment, I just wanted to share an experience I had yesterday. I know we're all probably feeling a little stir crazy, a little technology limited, like how is our hope, that kind of thing. So I know I've been struggling a bit with being in the same place because I'm never in the same place for very long. But I was on a call with, it turned out, about 100 other studio owners yesterday. And just watching all their faces pop up from all over, you know, there were people from all over Africa. There was someone from Australia, New Zealand. It was 2 a.m. in New Zealand. It was so inspiring to see their faces. And they went around and just asked everyone about their mood. And as I was going to say, my mood was a little frustrated. What I kept hearing from them was just hope and grounded and, you know, connected and peaceful. And it just really gave me a strong connection to kind of my yoga community of like external yoga owners that are out here trying to make this possible, you know, here on Zoom, but even more so hopefully when COVID is over and we're able to get together in the studio. So I just wanted to share that with you. I'm going to share a quick quote before we get started. Sometimes our light goes out, but it's blown again into instant flame by an encounter with another human being. So let's go ahead. If you're not muted, go ahead and mute yourself just so there's not kind of crackly noises. And I'll try to keep watching for Sandy. And let's go ahead and start in child's pose. So you're going to kneel on your mat. Take your feet out wide. Start to send your tailbone down towards your heels. And then you're going to reach out with the hands all the way out in front of you on the mat, taking your forehead down towards the mat. And just begin to allow yourself to settle in here, kind of dropping into this space. And beginning to bring your awareness to your breath. As you inhale, just beginning to invite peace and quiet and a connection down to your mat, to the earth right now. And beginning to let go of anything that may be on your mind, any stress, something from your day. Really connecting to your personal yoga space as it is here now. And just set an intent right here for your class. So whatever it is that brought you here today, set that intention. Maybe it's about connection or maybe something else that you're working on. Nice. Pick up your hands, walk your hands off to the right side of the mat. So you'll stay in child's pose. Hands are still reaching out front. The hands are off to the right side. And you're beginning to find that space on the left side of your body. Nice. And bring the hands back towards the center and walk them off towards the left. Really reaching a lot. Again, this time finding space on the right side of your body. Nice. And then back to the center. Go ahead and press yourself up. Find your way into all fours. So here your palms are on the mat. You're going to begin to arch your back, lifting your head up, your pelvis up towards the sky, letting your belly sink down towards the mat, finding cat and cow. And then you're going to round, tucking chin and pelvis under, lifting the navel up towards the spine. And just keep going with your breath. Inhaling as you arch and exhaling as you round. So whatever pace works for you is where you want to be, listening to your body. Take her upstairs, please. And just finding a couple more. You can add any movement you like. If you feel like you want to add some circles around, finding some space on your side body, Take it where you need, whatever you need today. Begin to make your way into downward facing dog, tucking the toes in the back. Seriously. Lifting the knees off the mat, pressing into downward facing dog. Nice. You're going to root your palms into the mat here a lot. Maybe add a bend in your knees as you need to, straightening one leg, bending the other if that feels nice for you. Adding any movement you'd like. You can lift a leg up, kind of send it to the back, maybe opening your hips or possibly switching to the other side. Nice. And then as you're ready, pressing back into down dog and looking to your hands, beginning to walk your feet all the way forward. So keeping your hips, your feet about hips distant, add a little bend in the knees, take hold of your elbows. Hang here. Kind of releasing head and neck and surrendering there. Go ahead and release your hands down to the mat and slowly roll yourself up, coming one vertebrae at a time all the way to the top. Roll it, allowing the shoulders to come down last, and then finding your palms at your heart center. Nice. As you're ready, we're going to lower down. Inhale, sweeping up and towards the sky. Turning the palms as you're ready, floating over, leading with the chest. Taking the hands down to the shins or to the floor. Looking out, flattening the back, and then stepping back into Holocaust, top of a push-up. And just kind of linger here for a moment. So really kind of energizing your body. The top of the head reaches forward, the heels press back, navel presses up towards your spine, and then as you're ready, taking it through your vinyasa. Maybe that means dropping your knees or coming forward, hugging the elbows in as you lower to chaturanga. Inhaling to up dog or cobra. And then exhaling back, downward facing dog. And big breaths again. In and out your nose, maybe finding ujjayi breaths. Good, finding one more big breath here. Then we're going to take the right leg, lift it up, send the heel toward the back. Go ahead and bend the knee, planting the foot between your hands. And for this first one, let's drop the back knee down onto the mat. Let's take the hands up onto the right knee, shifting the hips forward as you inhale and reach up towards the sky. Finding a low lunge here, standing through the fingers, allowing the heart to lift. And again, coming back to your breath. Beautiful, one last breath here. And then just take the hands down, planting the palms, one on each side of the foot, tucking the toes in the back. Take your back foot and just bring it to the front. Take the hands onto the shins this time as you inhale, looking out, flattening your back. Exhale, fold over, forehead towards the shins. And then inhale, sweep, reaching all the way up towards the sky. Nice, palms together and bring them back to your heart center. Beautiful, lower down, inhale, sweep, reaching up. Turn the palms as you're ready, exhale, floating over. Hands to the shins or the floor, inhale, look out. Exhale, step or float back, Halakasana. Engaging the core, lowering down as you're ready, Chaturanga. Inhaling up, dog or cobra. And exhale back, downward facing dog. Taking a couple breaths here in down dog, again, pressing through the palms. Especially that area where your fingers come into your palms. Pressing the pads of your fingers down into the earth, growing long here from the fingertips up to the tailbone, and then long from the tailbone down towards the heels. Good. Lift your left leg up in the back. Extend your heels back. And then bend the knee, bring your left foot forward between your hands. First time, drop your right knee down to the mat. Press your hip bones forward. Maybe the hands stay here on the knee. Or sweep up, reaching to the sky, allowing the heart to lift. Nice big breaths. And one last breath. Then you're going to plant the palms down again, one on each side of the left foot, tucking the toes in the back, bringing the back foot to the front. Inhale here as you look out. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, sweep, reaching up to the sky, extend the fingers tall. Let's keep the hands up there this time. Reach nice and tall. And then just take your hands and reach over towards the right side. Pressing nice and strong through the feet, really reaching a lot through the left hand. And then inhale, come back up to the top. Exhale, come to the other side, reaching strong. Beautiful, back up to the top. And now just bend the knees, sitting back and finding your Utkatasana. So pressing that tailbone towards the back, starting to tuck it under. Engage your core, navel pulls through your spine, your fingers extend out. We're gonna sit nice and deep, so reach your hands straight ahead and start to bend down as if you're kind of on that ski lift. Really big breath, engaged and strong here, and then straighten and fold down. Inhaling again as you look out. Exhale, step or float back. Flow through your vinyasa, your pace. You're gonna end up back in downward facing dog, taking a few breaths here. Remembering that as you practice, your vinyasa is always optional. So if it's somewhere that you don't wanna go today, you don't need to. You can always skip it, come right to down dog. And also keep in mind that child's pose is always available for you if you need it. Nice, send the right leg to the back. Press your heel back strong. Pushing back as if you wanna push into that back wall behind you. Bend the knee now, open up your right hip, lifting the knee to the sky, and starting to send that foot over towards the left side. Beautiful. As you exhale, take the knee all the way forward towards your nose or forehead, lingering for a moment, and then planting that foot between your hands. Nice. So Anjaneyasana, this time we're gonna come up with the back knee off the ground. Hands come to the knee for stability if you need to, or reach up nice and tall. Big breath here. Really connecting to the earth, thinking about from your hips down, grounding to the mat, and then growing from that place. Fingers lift tall. Awesome, we're gonna turn to the right now. So as you turn, you're gonna open the arms out, extending front and back. And on your exhalation, just take the left hand down, plant it here on the inside of your right foot, opening that right arm up and towards the sky. Sending the fingers tall. Big breaths. Bringing your intent to right now. So whatever that was that you set, can you bring it to this place? Good, send the right hand back down. Now press off with your back foot. We're gonna come onto the right foot in the front, floating the back foot up. Walk the fingers out under the shoulders. Option to stay right here, keeping that back leg engaged, or maybe you start to float your hands. Maybe you bring them back beside you. Airplane, asana, or straight out ahead if you'd like, warrior three. Big breaths, nice, one more. And then plant the hands back down on the mat. Let your left foot float to the back. Step your right foot back and flow through. Vinyasa. Whenever we take a vinyasa, it's kind of our way of clearing out, letting anything go from our body, finding our way back to home base, down dog, where we again check in with our breath, with our body, with our intention. Good, lift your left leg, send your heel back. Pressing strong to the back of your room, bending the knee, open the left hip up, lift the knee to the sky. And then bring that knee forward, hovering for a moment by your chest, landing that foot between your hands. Sweeping up as you're ready, or keeping the hands on the knee if you'd like. Anjaneyasana, fingers reach to the sky. Back leg is engaged. bandhas are working. Your navel pulls in toward your spine, nice and strong. Beautiful. And then checking in with your breath. If you're practicing ujjayi breath, you should be able to hear that breath. If not, turn it up. Now you start to turn towards your left, reaching the hands out front and back. So the lower part of your body stays the same as you rotate left. Nice, one more breath. And then right hand comes down to the mat on the inside of your left foot and open your left arm up and towards the sky. Working to stack those shoulders, really pulling up with the left hand as you strongly root into the mat with the right. And then take the left hand back to the mat. Slowly walk your hands forward a little, pushing off with your back foot, coming to float. Engage your back leg a lot, keep it strong. Maybe keeping the fingers to the earth here or even just floating. Maybe bring them back beside you for airplane, asana, or maybe reaching out where you're free. Big breath. Nice. One more. And then slowly exhale, planting your hands back down, plant your right foot down next to your left. Bend the knees, send your tailbone to the back, sweeping up. Sitting back, Utkatasana. Nice. Pull through your fingers, nice and long here. Breathe, good. I'm gonna take the hands right to the heart center. We're gonna start to turn to the right. So as you do, you're gonna take the left elbow to the right side of the knee. Take the right elbow towards the sky. Twisting your body towards the right. Hugging the knees together. Try not to let the left knee come ahead of the right. As you find that twist. And then slowly making your way back to the center and then off to the left, right elbow to the outside of the knee, left elbow towards the sky. And back to the center again. Go ahead and straighten your legs, folding down, planting the hands on the mat. Inhale as you look out. Exhale, step or float back. And flow through your vinyasa. Nice. We're going to take the right leg and lift it up to the sky. Now listen, we're going to walk our hands to the back. So hands come all the way back as you start to pull your forehead in towards your shin. Your right leg lifts up all the way. Nice. All right, and then from here, you're gonna bend both the knees, tucking the right knee behind the left and sitting into a little squat. Nice, and then we're gonna straighten out again, standing splits. And then we're gonna find a little squat again, right knee behind the left, squatting down. And then standing up again, standing splits. Nice, one more time, squatting down. Right knee behind the left. One more time, standing splits. Nice, now you're gonna look out on your mat ahead of you. Bend both your knees. Try to keep your right foot off the mat if you can. Slowly coming up to balance on your left foot. And then bringing that right foot up for Vrikshasana or tree. Coming to the inside of your left leg, above or below your knee. You're gonna press the right knee back. Palms come to your heart center. Or maybe some other arm variation. Maybe you're kind of a floating tree today. And you're nice and sturdy. You have the arm balance and you wanna practice that. Remember, you're on your mat in your space, taking your practice where you need to be today. You feel really balanced here and wanna challenge yourself. Start to gaze up to the sky. Maybe take a little back bend even, or close your eyes. Awesome, we have one more breath here. You're gonna take the knee forward, lift it all the way up, start to send it to the back. Really brief warrior three, as you float your hands down,
and walk back out, finding a three-legged plank. So checking in at your shoulders or over your wrist, right leg pressed to the back. Make sure your butt's not up here like this and you're not sagging down. You're gonna take the right knee towards the right elbow, send it back. Still in plank, right knee, right elbow, send it back. One more, right elbow, send it back. Three-legged dog. And then take your right foot down next to your left. Take a couple breaths. Nice. We're gonna do the other side. So take your left leg, extend your heel to the back, nice and long. And again, we're gonna walk the hands back. Continue to lift that left leg up as you pull the forehead down, standing splits. And then finding three squats. So nice and slow, left knee comes behind the right, you squat down, stand up, standing splits. Do it again, left knee behind the right, squat down, nice and tall, standing splits. Last one, squat down, standing splits. Awesome, shift your gaze, it's gonna help you balance. Add a little bend in your right knee as you slowly float up. Trying to keep your balance on your right foot. Taking your time, bend the left knee, take your foot to the inside of your right leg. Palms at your heart center. Beautiful. Left knee presses to the back as the hip bones push forward. Maybe the arms reach up, maybe they're to the sides. Hit your tree, wherever you need to be. Awesome, just another breath. Then we're gonna slowly make our way back down. So knee to the front, float it off. Start to kick it back, really brief, warrior three. As you plant your hands down, walk your hands forward. Nice three-legged plank, nice and strong. Left knee to the left elbow, send it back. Left knee to the left elbow, send it back, still in plank. One more, knee to the elbow, send it back. Plank, drop your knees. Press your tailbone to your heels. Take a rest in child's pose. Take a couple breaths here. When you're ready, if you want to grab some water, feel free to grab some water. Good, and then as you're ready, make your way back into down dog. So pressing the palms onto the mat again, lifting the knees. Press back, working to make your body shake more like a V. So the palms root to the mat. We're again working to get long from the fingertips up to the tailbone, from the tailbone down to the heels. Front of your thighs press backwards, navel pulls into your spine, one big breath. Awesome, lift your right leg, send your heel back. Now bend your knee, bring that foot forward between your hands, flatten your back. We're gonna come to warrior two. So you're gonna turn your body to the left side of your room, reach your arms up, and then extend them out. I need a big bend in your right knee. So looking for somewhere coming towards a 90 degree bend. Doesn't have to be that deep. Wherever you are is where you need to be. Looking down though to make sure that that right knee is coming off to the right a little so that you can see your big toe from the inside of the knee. Nice, big breath. And then send the left hand down onto your back leg, turn the right palm to face the sky. Rotate backwards, pulling back through the fingers. Nice, and then we're gonna come all the way forward. Planting both the hands down on the mat. You're gonna rotate your back foot. Now you're gonna really plant the left hand a lot. Come to the outer edge of your left foot as you step your right foot back, making your way into side plank. Right arm reaches to the sky. So you're on the left hand, left foot. Right arm reaches up. If you need to drop your left knee, feel free to drop your left knee. Listening to your body. You got it. Nice. Now listen, we're going to take the elbow and knee towards each other, and then you're going to start to take this right foot, bring it all the way forward, plant it on the mat. Both your hands down on the earth. Awesome. And then from here, you're going to lift your back leg up, bend it, and just place your foot next to your right. Beautiful. Inhale as you look out. Exhale as you fold down. And inhale, sweep, reaching all the way to the sky. Nice and tall, palms together. Find your heart center. Good. All right, lower down, inhale, sweep. Turn the palms, exhale and float. Inhaling as you look out. Exhale, step or float back, flowing through your vinyasa. Big breath in your down dog. And then lift the left leg to the back, press back through the heel. Bending that knee as you're ready, bring your foot forward between your hands, flattening the right foot in the back. Opening up as you sweep up into warrior two, facing the right side of the room now. That left foot is forward. Nice big bend in your left knee. As you look down, make sure your knee's not on the inside. It kind of rolls exterior, toward your exterior, so that you can see that big toe inside the knee. Big breaths. Core is strong, your heart is lifted. Looking to find contentment here, where you are. Take the right hand down, turn your left palm up to face the sky. Rotate backwards, finding that space on the left side of your body. Nice, and then windmill forward, plant your palms, both palms on the mat. Now we're going to end up in side plank, so you're going to rotate on that back foot until you get to the outer edge of the back foot, keeping the weight on the right palm, right foot, and the left foot back. Open the left arm up to the sky. Again, keeping in mind, you can modify, dropping the right knee. You can go bigger if you'd like. Maybe the left leg lifts. Wherever you need to be. Oops. And then we are going to lift that left leg a little, hug the elbow and knee together. Work to place your left foot in front. Nice. Sit by your hands. Float your back foot off. Place your right foot next to your left. Inhale here as you look out. Exhale, fold down. Inhale, sweep, reaching all the way to the sky. Nice. Palms together and find your heart center. Beautiful. Lower down, inhale, sweep, nice and tall. Turn the palms, exhale and float. Inhale as you look out. Exhale, step or float through your vinyasa, finding chaturanga, up dog, and down dog. Take your right leg back. Bend your knee, open your hip again, squeezing that foot in towards your hip. This time, if you'd like, starting to float your right hand off the mat. Eventually landing the right foot down and opening up into a flip dog if you'd like. Not somewhere you have to go, totally up to you. You guys look beautiful. One more breath, flipped. Unflip yourself. Nice. And then bend your right knee and plant your right foot between your hands. Awesome. You're going to flatten your back foot, come up to stand again facing the left, this time with a straight right leg. Good, so we're gonna come into Trikonasana Triangle. Bend your arms all the way out and start to reach forward as far as you can. Eventually sending your right hand maybe to your shin, maybe to a block or a book, maybe the floor. Left arm reaches to the sky. So you don't want your right hand to be above your knee. So you want it to be on your shin or lower, ideally, because you don't wanna put strain on your knee. You want your right quad to be engaged, protecting that knee. And then as you reach up with the left hand, consider trying to get your body in one plane. So shoulder over shoulder, hips over hip. Both the feet root to the ground, looking for balance between your feet to the extent you can. Nice. We're gonna just send the left arm forward, just the left arm. So So it kind of reaches right there by your ear. You're still opening your triangle. You're going to float your right hand off, engage your core, and then slowly come all the way to the top. Nice. We're going to come back the same way. You're going to come forward, two hands, engage your core, bend the right hand down. One more time into Trikonasana, left hand reaches up. And then you're going to turn down toward the mat, plant the palms, framing the right foot, rotate on your back foot, and this time take your back knee down to the earth. Perfect. You're going to take the right hand over to the inside and then start to lower yourself down onto your elbows. So there's a lot of places you can go from here. You can stay right here in your elbows. You can begin to slide your right arm under. You know, tucking that shoulder under. Maybe just staying here with the fingers. You can come off your back knee if you'd like, maybe floating. If you have the arm balance and you want it, feel free to take it. Or sometimes it's nice just to hang out here, elbows on the ground, even letting this right knee fall off to the right and beginning to find some more spaciousness there through your hip. So you have a couple more minutes to play, or a couple more breaths, I guess you should say, not minutes really, to play and see what works best for you. Maybe trying one variation, maybe coming into another. And then slowly bring your hands back up onto the mat. So there's the arms are straight again. Keep your left hand here on the mat. You're gonna bend your back leg up. You may just bend it partway off the ground. Maybe you're able to reach around behind you, taking hold of that better ankle. Kind of beginning to pull it towards you, rolling the right shoulder open, maybe opening your body up a bit to the sky. Finding a quad stretch in that back leg. Good, and then just releasing it down. Planting the palms back on the mat, one on each side. Tuck the toes in the back, step the right foot back. Either press into down dog, or if you want a vinyasa, feel free to take it. Clearing out, coming back to home base. Back to downward facing dog. Taking a couple breaths here. Checking in with your body, with your breath, with your intention. Nice. And then you're going to take the left leg lifted up in the back. Bend your knee, open the hip up. Take your time slowly flipping over if you'd like. Left arm reaching towards the front of the room, finding your flip dog. Totally an option. You do not have to flip. Remember to listen to your body. One more breath if you're here. Go ahead and flip yourself back, sending the left leg to the back, and then bend that knee, bring your foot forward between your hands, flatten your back foot again, coming to stand. We're coming into Trikonasana, triangle. Your body's now facing the right. You're gonna reach those arms up and out, keeping the left leg straight, begin to reach forward as far as you can. Sending that left hand down, shin, the floor, maybe a book or a block. Right arm reaches up to the sky. The left leg is engaged. So really important here is you're kind of folding over this straight leg that you have a little micro bend in that left knee. Your quad is working strong. Big breaths. Nice. Then everything stays the same except the right arm. Just reach it forward towards the front. Uddita or extended Trikonasana, really long down the right side of your body. Engage your core, float your left hand off. Take your time slowly coming up to the top. We're going to come right back through. So keep the arms extended, engage your core, reach to the front two arms. Take the left hand down to your shin or the floor, right arm up. And then turning down towards your left foot, framing that foot as you drop the right knee down. And then just go ahead and take your left hand to the inside as well. So kind of your option to take it where you'd like now. Maybe elbows to the mat. Maybe you slide that left arm underneath your leg, reaching fingers out or even floating your back foot. What do you need right now? That's where you want to go. Always remembering as you practice, this is your practice. Always looking to find what it is that you need today. Our bodies are not always the same from day to day. We have to listen to them. Good, slowly come back up, taking both hands to the inside of your left foot if they're not there already. Keep the right hand down. Start to bend your left knee up in the back. See how that feels? Maybe you have just a small bend. Or maybe you reach back, take hold of that foot. Kind of pulling it towards you a bit as you open your left shoulder. Beginning to turn your body up and towards the sky. If it doesn't feel good to have a hold of that foot, you can stay with your left hand kind of on your knee, just finding the rotation there. Nice. And then release it, turning back towards the mat, planting the palms. Go ahead and just take your left foot back so you're back on all fours. From here, we're just going to lower ourselves down to the earth. So coming all the way down onto your belly, go ahead and turn your head for a moment and just surrender. So let everything go for just a moment. Feel the weight of the body, the gratefulness of the floor holding you here. Maybe the connection to your mat, to your space, to right now. Good. We're going to send the arms out ahead of us. So reach them out. Let the palms face each other. We're going to find just one Salambasana today. So as you're ready, float your legs off. Maybe push your hands into the earth, kind of lifting your body slightly, and then reaching out to extend those fingers forward. So it's as if you're trying to float everything off the ground, keeping the hip bones down on the earth and extending. So it's more about length than lift. The fingers forward, the toes back. Take one more breath. Exhale down. Turn your head the opposite way and rest. Again, surrendering the weight of your body down, letting go. Good, and then one small back bend while we're here. So turn yourself, your head back towards the center, let the chin rest on your mat. You're gonna bend the legs in the back, reach back, grab hold of the feet or the ankles. From here, before you even work to come up into bow pose, you're gonna bring the knees towards each other, flex your feet, and then begin to lift the legs off the mat a little, kicking to the back. Lifting the chest, you're lifting the chin. You may find that your body rocks a bit as you're here. Everybody's different, it doesn't matter how big your bow is, Dhanurasana. One more breath, release it down. Nice, you can release your hands. Keep the knees bent and then just let your feet fall side to side. And then from there, take your hands next to your chest, press up again onto all fours. And then we're just gonna kind of walk the knees forward, coming back to a seated position. If you need some water, feel free to grab a drink. We're gonna extend the legs straight out ahead of us, flexing the feet back, making sure you can find your sit bone. So if you need to kind of shift the weight around to find yourself sitting strongly on the sit bones, find that. Press the legs into the earth, inhale, reach to the sky. Nice and tall, as you exhale, reach the hands out, kind of thinking about reaching past your feet as far as you can, grabbing what you can reach, whether it be your toes, your ankles, your shins, whatever that is, grab a hold. And now lift again through your chest. Press the bottom, the backs of your legs into the earth. Finally pulling forward, trying to get to the point eventually where maybe your belly's resting on your legs. When you get there, you can let go of that lift in your chest and continue to reach yourself forward, pulling the forehead down wherever it goes. If you don't get to that point yet today where you're resting on your legs, you're gonna find more space if you keep lifting up through your heart and pressing your legs down and into the earth. You'll find whatever works for you there. Feeling that work in the back of the legs. Take one more breath. And slowly come up from there. Bend the legs and take the bottoms of your feet together. So pressing the feet towards each other, you're gonna start to let the knees fall down, holding onto the feet or ankles to help you lift up through your heart. Working to press your shoulders towards the back. Then you're gonna grab a hold of your big toes. So two fingers to each big toe. You're gonna start to pull them off the ground as you kind of find your way back to a balance. If it doesn't feel possible to balance with both off, you can try just one. We're gonna slowly start to open them. So finding your way maybe here, maybe out a bit more, maybe eventually all the way out. And when you get here, instead of being slumped like this, you wanna lift your heart, kind of roll the shoulders down your back. If you have space, I don't have space where I am. If you have space and you like to roll, feels nice on your spine, feel free to roll back, tap your feet behind you, come back to this place. Even if you don't have room to quite tap, you can always kind of find your way back up. Kind of a nice fun core as well to get there. A little massage on our spines that have probably been spending a lot of time sitting. Awesome. Go ahead and bring the legs together and then release them and find your way into boat. Avasana. Beautiful. Navel pulls to your spine. If you need support here, grab a hold of your legs, the back of your legs. Lift your heart a lot. You could even settle your feet down towards the ground or all the way up. One more breath. And halfway down. Now take your palms together and then you're going to tap your elbows on each side. So tap. Tap, tap, tap navel to your spine. Keep going. Nice. Two more. Reach out and then all the way down to your mat. Surrender here for a moment. Let everything go. Awesome. We're going to find one more core exercise. So take your hands back behind your head and release your hands. Go ahead and lift your legs up so your knees are bent about 90 degrees. Your shins are parallel to the ground. And then from here, you're going to extend your right leg. Take it almost to the earth, almost to where you tap as your right shoulder comes towards the left knee. So you're working to bring the shoulder forward, not the knee. Switch to the other side. So take it nice and slow. It's harder as you go slow. Keep breathing. Remember your elbows stay back. You're working to bring your shoulders forward. Awesome. Two more on each side. One more. Come back to the center, grab hold of the knees, kind of pull them in towards you and just rock yourself a little up and down. Good. So we're going to find one more back bend right here. We're going to find bridge or wheel. So for a bridge, as you lie back, shoulders on the earth, feet rooted to the ground, you're gonna just tuck the shoulders under and lift the hips up. And this is your bridge. You can, if you want, interlace your hands underneath, wiggle your shoulders together. Maybe use that to lift up more. If you know wheel and you prefer wheel, hands up by your ears, lifting your whole body up and off the ground. Listening to your body today and what you need. Finding a couple more breaths if you have it. And slowly making your way back down. Awesome. And from there, just pulling the knees in, send the bottoms of your feet up to the sky. Grab a hold of the feet or ankles, pulling the knees down for a happy baby. So in happy baby, as you grab a hold of the feet or ankles, a lot of times your tailbone comes way up off the ground. You're gonna try to press it down. Kind of trying to balance between the tailbone coming down and the knees coming to the earth. And maybe taking it side to side a bit if that feels nice for you. good. And from here, optional inversion if you want it. We have just a couple minutes for it. An inversion can be if you had a block or even a blanket or a pillow, you could kind of put it right underneath you. I have a pillow in here. And you could bring that here and even just send your legs up. And there's a little mild inversion, allowing the blood to return up. The next easiest one after that would be to tuck the shoulders under for a shoulder stand, lifting off hands to the lower back. If that's a new one for you, you may want to wait until we're kind of in person in the studio. If you have another practice, handstand, headstand, up to you. Wherever you need to be, it's a really nice way to end our practice to have our feet over our heart, allowing that blood to return back. We're going to stay for just about a minute. And then whenever you're ready, you can start to bring yourself back, coming back in onto your mat. Go ahead and lie yourself back down. We're gonna make our way towards Shavasana. So let's just find a twist first. So from a reclining position, just bend your knees and you can just drop the knees off to one side. So just kind of letting them both fall. Or you can also, as your knees fall to the right, you can cross your left leg over the right, making it a little bit bigger twist, if you'd like. Kind of creating some neutrality in your spine before we find Shavasana. And then go ahead and switch to the other side, bringing the knees up, dropping them to the other side. And if you want the leg on top, if you're going to the left, it's the right leg on top of the left as you twist. Good. Go ahead and release that. And then find your way into your Shavasana. So release your legs back out. Extend your arms out beside you with your palms up. Take the legs far enough apart that you can kind of just drop your feet off to the side. Nice. And then just surrender. Working to let everything go. No control here of your breath, of your body.
Shadow. down from here. If morning ever comes to be, be still, be still, be still. If you forget the way to go and lose where you came from, if no one stands.
Slowly bring your awareness back to your breath. Let yourself remain still for a moment. And just allow the breath to return back into your body, bringing energy and prana and light back in. Feeling that connection to your mat one more time, to your breath. Then beginning to add movement in your body, fingers, toes, maybe wrists or ankles. Maybe rocking a little side to side, beginning to hug the knees in towards your chest. Slowly waking up. And then just eventually finding your way back into a seated position, keeping the eyes closed for just a moment. Letting the hands rest down on your knees. I'm gonna take one last big breath here. Taking a breath in, as you exhale, blow it out, releasing anything that you don't need, just sending that off. And then just bringing the hot palms together at your heart center. Take a moment right here to thank yourself for your practice, for the work you did tonight on your mat, for showing up here. Connection is why we're here. It's what gives purpose and meaning to our lives. So I encourage you as you go off your mat to make your connections, whether they be virtual, sometimes real if we have some family members we're quarantining with. Use them to keep your light. So bring your palms up towards your forehead. And then just bowing down, honoring those around you. Namaste. Thank you, guys. Thanks for coming. Feel free to unmute.
Thank you, Susan.
Thank you, Susan.
Thank you, Susan.
You're welcome. If anyone has feedback, please let me know. We're going to get that beginning portion of class fixed soon as people connect to Zoom more. So nice to see all your faces.
Thank you, Susan.
All right.
That was great. Thank you.
Happy Tuesday. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Here's Holly. Nice to see you guys in Dallas.
Good to see you.
You too. Absolutely. Take care.
Yeah.
See ya.
Okay. Bye. See you, Holly.
Bye.